Hey, welcome back to the channel, Divine Timing, We Are Rising. I'm your messenger, Shira, and I am back with another divinely guided, intuitive channel message just for you collective. All right, so y'all, today is going to be one of those days where I am simultaneously just getting these fucking readings out, okay? I'm channeling a lot, okay? There's a lot going on here. I just did another reading that I thought was loading and processing. However, it wasn't, unfortunately. So I'm going to wait to upload it until this reading is up. Hold on. Until this reading is up. Because, yeah, it was just too much going on, y'all. But, yeah, go ahead and like this video, please. And thank you, you guys. And thank you to 400 subscribers. I greatly appreciate it, you guys. It really means a lot. Also, I'm trying to see what the fuck I'm up. My high ass. Anyways, also, if you guys aren't already, please go ahead and check out my main channel at LovelyFlyShy. Okay. Also follow me on Instagram at _LovelyFlyShy_. Twitter at LovelyFlyShy. I join the fam bam, you dig? Especially if you vibe high, all right? You about this truth. Okay, so we have some 432 hertz, all right, on. We're gonna be attracting some abundance, money, prosperity, luck, and wealth, divine abundance. Breathe. I'm doing the same. Oh shit. Light some Palo Santo. Y'all, so much has been going on, but I really feel like this energy, like, you guys definitely need to breathe. You know, focus on your breathing. I'm getting an energy. It's like someone isn't breathing properly. Okay, so focus on that. Okay. So to just jump right into, don't mind this flame, you guys. I just kind of infatuated with fire. Does that make me? Oh man, that makes me. But anyway. Let's cleanse the energy. So there is a heavy, there's like heavy revelations. Oh crap. Being exposed at this time, you guys. There's a lot of different truths, a lot of different knowledge that you all are coming into in terms of, hold on. Fuck. I just spilled that shit everywhere. Anyway, this is in relation to like your spiritual awakening. This could have a lot to do with your spiritual gifts, okay? These upgrades that are taking place. I'm definitely picking up on an energy. It's like you guys are able to manifest really, really easily at this time. All it takes is ensuring that your energy is aligned, okay? But I'm definitely feeling like you guys are in a very harmonious period of just receiving, okay? You guys have taken so many losses. I'm hearing over the past 5 to 7 years, you have just taken so many different hits, so many different losses. You've just experienced so many different, hold on, because I feel like I'm screaming over this music. I'll cut that back on in a minute. Okay, you guys have experienced so many different obstacles. What the fuck? Y'all seen that shit? Okay, y'all, that shit just really turned back the fuck home. I'm glad I caught that shit on camera. Lord. Okay, anyway. Yeah, so like you guys have just been going through different obstacles, different trials and tribulations again over the past 7 years. And now you're walking into this period of just being able to shit, ask for it. Like literally ask and you shall receive. And what I mean by that is just if you want If you want to be in a different environment, ask for it, you know, and take action to put yourself in the position, in that position, okay? We have a shocking exposure, okay? So, yeah, I mean, I'm definitely picking up on the fact that you guys are just realizing your power. You're realizing that you do have more power, more courage, and more strength than you guys give yourself credit for. Okay. Yeah, we have placeholder here. Okay. So there is a placeholder in the energy. This could be your person. Right behind that, we have bossy. Okay. So you all could be in this very bossy energy in your own right, you know, as you should be. When it comes to, I'm definitely hearing this has a lot to do with like finances. Okay, a lot of you are really just stepping your game up, you're leveling up mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally, and financially. All right, there are many different things happening in your life. Okay, you are definitely upgrading, you are elevating, especially those of you who are actually, you know, taking care of yourselves. You know, you are focusing on yourself. You're not a part of any drama, any malice. You're not jealous. You're not envious of other people. You're not hating on other people. You know, those of you who know that you're in this abundant energy, this energy that, excuse me, I fucked up with this abundant, but yeah, I am abundant. You know that you are abundant. You know, you attract money with ease. Okay, this is the energy you all are walking in at this time. And this is the energy that your ancestors have been really pushing and propelling you all to walk in for a while now. But I feel like a lot of you have been doubting yourself. You've been doubting your confidence. You've been doubting whether or not it's too much. Yeah, there are people who think that you being as confident as you are is perhaps maybe egotistical, or they think that you're just bougie and bossy and things like that. But these same motherfuckers don't understand all of what it took for you all to get to this point. All right? You guys had to take a lot of losses. You had to learn a lot of lessons. And now you are being upgraded. Okay? Now you are being rewarded from spirit. All right? So someone here can't feel the love, okay? Perhaps this is your energy. Maybe you don't feel, you know, your person's love, okay? Maybe you're beginning to realize that your person was merely just a placeholder, okay? A karmic lesson, all right? And it's a shocking exposure for you to see that this person that you have always admired, that you have always had just a deep, deep, heavy amount of love for, that they could just turn around and, excuse the music in the background, but that they can just turn around and just say fuck you and walk away, you know, for whatever reason. But here they are back at this energy of feeling like they're angry at God for letting you slip away. Okay? But it's like they didn't show you that they wanted to keep you. They didn't show you that they wanted to have you in their lives. They always gave you the bare minimum. Okay, they always held themselves back from you all because they were afraid. They were afraid of love, but that's still no excuse for them to mentally and emotionally abuse you and think that they weren't going to receive any karma behind it. You don't just go around fucking over divine beings of light, love, and so on. You know, there are repercussions for fucking over God's chosen vessels. Seriously. You don't have the right to leave me behind. Wow. So this could be your person's energy towards you. They feel like you don't have the right to leave them behind. You don't have the right to awaken and ignite this bossy energy. You don't have the right to realize that this person was merely just a placeholder in your life and that they really meant you no good based off of everything that they went behind the scenes and did against you, waging different energy attacks towards you, spiritual warfare, and everything like that. sending you a bunch of negative energy. Now they're in this feeling. Now they're feeling like, oh, you don't have the right to leave me behind. Like, nigga, please. Like, and they treated y'all crazy, like foul. Okay, they didn't appreciate you. They didn't show you that they wanted, again, they didn't show you that they wanted you to be in their lives. They gave you their ass to kiss time and time again. And now Spirit is bringing in an actual true companion, an actual true divine counterpart, an actual true twin flame energy. Again, this person was merely just a lesson. Yeah, he's a jealous bastard. So this person could be fatherless. He's jealous. All right, he operates more in his feminine energy than anything. Okay? And so now this energy is feeling jealous. I mean, excuse me. Well, yeah, feeling jealous, but they are feeling angry at God for allowing you, Divine Feminine, to walk away and to walk into this bossy energy. Now they want to have the nerve to try to curse God. Now they really getting their asses whooped. Now they're really getting their asses handed to them. Because who the fuck do you think you are to come against the Most High and think that there will not be any repercussions? You know, this person is crazy. Yeah, they were doing magic on you the whole time. They were doing magic on you the whole time. Love spells, thought witchery, okay, word witchery. Okay, they was literally even trying to do rituals on you, doing different forms of magic on you. These people were definitely inexperienced, I hear. But these motherfuckers was connected though, but they weren't connected to the light side. They was connected and tapped in and initiated with the dark side, okay? And this is this shocking turn of events, which leads to this shocking exposure that you all are, you know, awakening to. Yeah. Sex is all I have to offer you. Period. If you were wondering, what is it? Why? This, that, whatever. Because this person can only offer you sex. They don't have any morals. They don't have any values. They don't have any dignity. They don't have any self-respect. They don't have any get up and go about themselves. They have no spirituality about themselves, okay? And so therefore, sex was all they'd be able to fucking offer you anyways. Mm-hmm. Karmic mothers secretly hate you. All right, so this can be your person's mother. This can be an ex karmic energy that you may have dealt with in the past, present, or here in the near future. Yeah, or this could be your mother, you know. Karmic mothers secretly hate you. And they could also be responsible for this magic as well. They're doing magic on you the whole time. Okay, these people are merely just placeholders in your life, okay? They're not the real deal. They're just tests, okay? They weren't meant to evolve and elevate and ascend with you, okay? Oh, wow. Now they want revenge. Mm-hmm. Now they want revenge. But it's like all they're doing is, again, cursing themselves. They are just racking up and stacking up their karmic debt that they will have to pay up. And the shit comes back. It comes back fast. You know, when you fuck with a light worker, a light being, okay, one of the elect, of the 144,000 elect, you will get fucked up, not only by their ancestors, angels, and so, and what have you, but also by the Most High, the universe, yeah, which is why their evil deeds is eating them up inside. I just heard dying inside, crumbling inside. Not knowing what to do, what to say. Yeah, unknowingly. They unknowingly betrayed you, not knowing your level of spiritual ranking. Not knowing your level of psychic abilities and intuitiveness. They thought you was just some fucking Looney Tune that deserved to be in a fucking loony bin some fucking where. But these bitches didn't realize that they was unknowingly waging war against themselves. They was unknowingly conjuring up your ancestors okay? And now they want revenge. All because their evil deeds is eating them up, all right? All because there's some fake-ass motherfuckers. They're fake, okay? They smile in your face. They a-key-key-key with you on the phone and everything else. They try to act like everything's all good in your face and in front of you, behind closed doors. And in their head, these motherfuckers is fake, and they've always been plotting on you. And they've always secretly hated you. Mm-hmm. Someone here is harboring past resentments toward the divine feminine. Okay, so this could be this false twin that I'm picking up on that has been recognized as of late as being a placeholder, as being a karmic lesson. This person has been harboring past resentment towards you, I'm hearing, over a lie. All over a lie that someone told them that they never have the courage to come up to you and be a fucking man and ask, hey, is this true? Is that true? But they wanted to harbor past resentments towards you, wanted to do magic on you the whole time, wanted to delay you, see? Wanted to delay you the whole time, wanted to stop you the whole time, and the list goes on. Yeah, they're reaching. Okay, they're reaching. You know, when it comes to you, when it comes to your success, when it comes to your glow up and your transformation, of course they're going to reach. They're going to try to pull anything out of their ass and over exaggerate. Yeah, someone here is this could be your person or a karmic energy. They're like, listen, I don't want nobody else to have you in the same way that I did. So this person is definitely giving me high narcissistic vibes. This is classic narc energy. So you wanted to treat the divine feminine like shit, okay? Not appreciate her, not see her value, not speak life into her, not, you know, whatever, but you claim to love her, but yet you don't want anyone else to have her? That's just insane. Yeah, there's questions. Okay, there's a lot of questions being asked about you, Divine Feminine, and about this person. This person's asking a lot of questions. But you are being guided, Divine Feminine, to forget the past. And with forgetting the past, that means forgetting this person. I know it may be hard for some of you. I know it may feel like something that you can't do, but it's time to literally get rid of these energies. Okay, yeah, we have sick and devious acts of the devil. All right, these people, you see how it fell out of my hand? Yeah, sick and devious acts of the devil, all right? Time to make a major move. All right, so it's time to make a major move and a major decision. All right, you all may be in your head questioning yourself, questioning the divine, but I'm hearing that you're being guided to just do what it is that needs to be done in terms of... you know, ensuring that you reach your final destination. Okay? Yeah, because these people wanted to send many stumbling blocks your way, you know, many obstacles. They kept you in a mental prison for many years. Like I said, it could have been 7 years, could have been 17 years. Seven is very significant here. You could have known this person for 7 years, 17 years. Or, again, could have been in a relationship for 7 years, a marriage for 7 years. All right, seven is significant here, though. Either way it goes, they realize that they have lost, okay? All right, so we have, yeah, they have lost the star. You continuously come up in this energy. In each reading, you're coming up as the star, upright in your energy, as being healed, being looked at as blessed and highly favored by the Most High, by the divine, because you are true to yourself. Okay, you don't have to be like anyone else. You don't have to have the same ideals as everyone else. You literally stand out. Okay, exactly. We have the Six of Wands here. Okay, you're very, very successful. All right, even if it's slow and steady. Of course, every good thing is going to take time, but you are rapidly growing. You are rapidly transforming. You are becoming better and better, Divine Feminine. Okay? You have a lot of admirers, I'm hearing also. You know, you're definitely in this bossy energy, this Six of Wands energy here. Okay? All right, we have the Lovers in the reverse. So, yeah. You know, I feel like you're still... You still have a soul tie with this person. I'm definitely getting an energy where it's time to really cut this cord with this person. 2022 is just on the clock, so this has to happen this year. Yeah, again, we have the Six of Cups coming out. Perhaps you all could have had history with this person. You could have longed for this person for a very long time, but also wanted to say that you could have known this person from a very long time. This card speaks of nostalgia, you know, childhood, reunion, things of that nature. But again, you have to understand that this person, whether unknowingly or knowingly, was trying to destroy you. You know, they were in a secret competition with you. Okay, they didn't know how to appreciate and or value you because they didn't know how to appreciate and value themselves. Yeah, we got the Hermit mode. We have the Hermit card. All right, so we have some Virgo energy here, some Earth energy. Okay, and then we have the Two of Swords, all right, in the reverse. So yeah, this has been a long battle, a long, exhausting battle of spiritual warfare that you all have been dealing with for many years, just dealing with different attacks, different setbacks, okay? And now that you all are walking into this very harmonious period of, wow, Queen of Pentacles is... Wow, upright. Yeah, you're in this Queen of Pentacles energy, okay? I'm hearing you're asking and you're receiving. No questions asked. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Yeah, this person wanted to block your Ace of Pentacles. Okay, and they were successful for a while there. Until, okay, the roles reversed. All right, you all have went into this Hermit mode and you started realizing what was going on behind the scenes, okay? And you began to protect yourself, you began to guard yourself and to set set boundaries. Exactly, we have the Judgment here. So three or more people could be getting judged at this time, okay, for going against you. Their karma could differ from each other's, or they could be going through similar stuff, okay? Losing out on their finances, not knowing shit, they don't, you know, robbing Peter to pay Paul. They don't know their left from their right. They don't know if they're coming or going at this time. All because they had you all stuck in this mental prison, in this illusion for a very long time. And now, again, this judgment is here. Now they're having to deal with what it is that they have sown. They're having to reap what it is that they have sown, I'm hearing. Tell me more, Spirit. Yeah, we have the Two of Cups in the reverse. Yeah, they made you all think that it was something that it wasn't. Okay, they led you all on for their own selfish needs. This could have been because of greed. This could have been in terms of anything. I feel like these are energy vampires. They just wanted your energy. Okay, you have really high energy. You're very, very charismatic. You're very loving. You have a gift of gab. You're very kind, you know? You know, and you are just like, you just embody a very strong energy. Like, you're very intuitive, you're very enlightened, you're very smart and educated. And this person wanted to turn you into who they wanted you to be, and it just did not happen that way. Okay, the High Priestess was just in the reverse on the floor, but you know, I ain't gonna pick that up. But yeah, they wanted to, you know, stop you from prospering and moving forward in your life. Yeah, we have the Queen of Swords and the Ten of Wands. Yeah, you sent that enemy and that energy right back to sender. And here they are stuck at this Ten of Wands energy, having to carry all of these heavy burdens. And they're even stuck in a mental prison. All because they wanted to come up against this Queen of Swords energy that they thought was once timid, shy, or they thought that you were like, I don't know. They probably thought you guys were like scary, weak, punks, whatever. But they didn't realize that you guys were fucking powerful, that you guys embodied this Queen of Swords energy. Okay, as well as this Two of Swords energy. You know how to go within, you know how to retreat, go into Hermit mode and scope out the ideals, scope out the oppositions. and you study them long before they ever try to study you. Okay? So they didn't know how, again, equipped you were and are. You know? But they're seeing now, as they are facing judgment for everything that it is that they have done to you. Okay? Yeah, the hangman. Again, this could be family, friends, anyone in your life who has betrayed you. They are now stuck up in their head, constantly having to realize or relive and realize everything that they have done to you, whether they acknowledge it or not. All right, yeah, we have this Knight of Swords energy in the reverse. This person ran away from you any chance they got. They always ran towards energies that they deemed better than you, that they put on a pedestal above you. But now that you are no longer in this person's energy field, it's like this person has all of these heavy burdens out of nowhere. They're having to carry alone, having to figure things out alone. People are actually walking out on this person, leaving this person stuck in the same ways in which this person walked out on you and left you stuck. Okay? Now they're on their last pinnacle trying to make something out of nothing, and they're thinking back on, you know, what it is that they could have had with you and what it is that they should have had. But it's just too late, because I feel like you guys don't even want this person anymore. You, if this is friends or family, you guys don't even want to deal with these people anymore. Okay, because they've shown you their true colors. You realize that ain't nothing good coming out of this situation dealing with these people. What do they bring except stress, heartache, drama? Yeah. Doing magic on you. That magic definitely has been reversed and sent back. You know, gossiping, slander, all of that. Now they're getting exposed as the fake ass motherfuckers that they are. All because they wanted to cast you in a negative light that did not belong to you. Yeah, they got behind the scenes trying to drum up all these fucking lies and excuses to try to save face. Until here we got the Temperance here, your angels, ancestors, the Most High. I'm hearing Archangel Michael and Gabriel came in and whipped these motherfuckers back into shape. Yes, Seven of Wands. Here they are trying to defeat all these odds. Here they are trying to fight back in a way. This spiritual warfare and these demonic attacks that they are now experiencing, because that is what they sent your way, the High Priestess. You don't have to move a muscle. You don't have to lift a finger. And you don't even have to think a negative thought towards these people. But intuitively, you know that these people are reaping karma for what it is that they have done to you. Okay? You meant nothing but good for these people. You have never talked negatively about this masculine energy who went behind the scenes due to their jealousy towards you. You have never talked negatively about them. But they had the nerve to disrespect you in front of these lousy ass, chicken tender placeholder ass friends of theirs who don't even give a fuck about them. They're fake as fuck, but your person is definitely going to have to learn the hard way. You know, they see you being victorious at the Six of Wands and the Star energy, and they're fighting all these different principalities and shit. Yeah, the King of Cups in the reverse. Now they got a funky ass attitude with everybody, trying to take their hateful ass energy out on motherfuckers like somebody really gives a fuck. They walking around like they got a stick up their ass, but no one gives a fuck. So yeah. Hierophant in the reverse. They're manipulative as fuck, abusive as fuck, controlling as fuck, possessive as fuck, always want to be the boss of something, always want to be in control of something, always got something fucking to say. Yeah. Feeling weak, okay? Feeling weak, tired, depressed, stressed, you know? Yeah, Queen of Cups. Again, this was this false twin flame, all right? This King of Cups here coming out. Your energy is upright. This person in the last couple of readings, their energy has been in the reverse each time. This person is not your divine counterpart. They are not your twin flame, all right? They are a karmic lesson. I know that that's a shocking exposure. I know that that's a hard pill to swallow, but it needs to be swallowed, because this person, they did not wish you any well. And yes, they are experiencing a tower moment. Okay, this is like 3 to 6 different energies that went up against you. For those of you who this resonates with. Okay, this could be a work-related situation. This could be in a familial situation. Regardless of what it is, these people fucked up royally. Yeah, sick and devious acts of the devil. All because they didn't want to see you in your energy. Okay, they didn't want to see you in this high priestess, queen of cups, star, and six of wands energy. We got the queen of pentacles out here. Look at you, girl, look at you coming out heavy. Heavy, heavy divine feminine energy. Heavy divine feminine energy. Look at you coming out heavy. Like, I can't make this shit up. They are intimidated by the fact that you can bounce back from anything. That you never needed them for shit. You never asked them for shit. All you wanted was to love their return. Like, ooh, excuse me. All you wanted to do was love their crazy asses. Okay? But you fucking took your energy back. You took your fucking power back. And bossed your fucking life up. And became exactly, you walking in your energy. You're exhibiting this strong goddesshood, goddess energy at this time. This divine feminine energy. Okay? All right, so give me some more messages, Spirit. Give me some more messages. Yeah, wisdom. All right? All this situation did was, even throughout the many years that it took you all to get to this point in which you guys are at now, in terms of this awakening, you realizing this deep truth, well, it just did nothing but made you wise, okay? It made you grow way beyond your years, okay? Orphan, okay? You all could have been an orphan. Like, you could have been in the system as a child, I'm hearing. Yeah, we have persecution and inquisition. So someone here is definitely being persecuted in a family and or a friend group. Okay, people are talking mad shit behind them. The same people they gossiped with you about are now not only walking out on them, but they're now talking shit about them. The family even talking shit about them. Like, people are sick of this person. I'm hearing the karmic even is walking out on this person. This person is literally about to be stuck like Chuck. Mm-hmm. I didn't want to pick it up because it's clarifying. We got the high priestess clarifying the high priestess, bro. Okay, you guys are very intuitive. We have, what is that, 10? Oh, no, that's, well, just pretend that's 11. Anyways. Yeah, we have the high priestess clarifying the high priestess. So you guys are very in tune. You're very wise, okay? You know what the fuck is up. No one can put anything over your fucking eyes. No one can put anything in your head and make you believe something that's not the real deal Holyfield. Okay? So, yeah. Anything else? 33 is just on the clock. Yeah, love life. All right, yeah, Atlantis, health. Okay, you guys are in good health. We have communal living. Yeah, they didn't know that you guys were connected to Atlantis. All right, that's where your ancestors come from. Okay, I'm hearing intuitively you all know that. Okay, all right, give me some more messages. Yeah, children. Okay, you can have 2 children with this person, or you can have 2 children, but your love life is being affected by children. So yeah, a lot of you are just being guided to focus on yourself and your children. You know, time to make this major move. Okay, for the betterment of self and children, I'm hearing. Oh, I didn't see that. Yeah, so reconciliation. We have reconciliation and retreat. Okay, so perhaps someone here may reconcile with their person, and you all will be guided to retreat from like social media, retreat from the world, you know, walk away from family, friends, and just toxic loved ones, coworkers, whatever, just people, places, and things that do not serve your highest good, and that deplete and delay, you know, your energy. Okay, bottom of the deck. Yeah, we have chemistry here. So there is a lot of chemistry here. It's just this person is operating in this fucking negative ass energy, this devil energy. It's very, very unfortunate. Well, that was the reading, you guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, please show me some love by giving the video a thumbs up. Also sharing the video on any of your platforms. That greatly helps out a lot, okay? And I appreciate it. I truly do. And until the next reading, divine timing, we are rising. And I am checking out. Peace and love.